science of love. What does it look like and is it real? What does your brain look like when it falls in love? We're now able to actually identify a lot of the biochemical changes, physiological changes, and physical changes that occur when someone falls in love. So now we can put a scientific basis to a lot of those phrases like love is blind and love is like a drug. So we'll just get right into it. The first change that happens, dopamine is released or increased. So dopamine is a neurotransmitter associated with things like pleasure, anticipation, and addiction. So this helps explain the feeling of the kind of happiness and the good feeling you get when you're around your partner. So Rutgers University actually did a study where they showed that MRI scans of people in the attraction stage of love showed an increased blood flow in areas with a high concentration of dopamine receptors in the brain, okay? And change number two is norepinephrine, also known as noradrenaline, also soars and skyrockets. So this helps explain and causes things like a racing heart and an overall feeling of exhilaration. So high dopamine and norepinephrine actually kind of go hand in hand here. They rev up the body similar to what would happen in a fight or flight response. Except in this case, instead of running from something, we're running towards something or towards somebody. So they together will produce things like high energy levels, euphoria, focus attention, loss of appetite, sleeplessness, a racing heart, and things of the like when you're around or thinking of the person you're actually in love with. They also help to explain things like motivation, craving, and desire to be with the person you like. So I don't know if you remember that rush you first had maybe on one of your first crushes in middle school back in the day, or possibly breaking into a sweat and feeling like your heart is pounding when they would enter into the room. Well, you can kind of use the information and kind of conclude to why that was happening. And believe it or not, some of these neurochemical changes we just discussed are quite consistent with early phases of addictive behavior. So it's been said that the brain of someone in love looks like the brain of someone that's on cocaine. And this may be why the phrase love is like a drug is so common today. And to be more specific, love is more like a stimulant kind of drug in this case. Change number three, the neurotransmitter serotonin actually goes down. So research at the University College in London, that's actually what it's called, showed this. So this has some similarities to what actually happens in OCD or obsessive compulsive disorder. And this is consistent with the obsessive nature and infatuation of early love. Serotonin is usually associated with things like happiness, but is also known as the break or stop neurotransmitter as well. So if you can't stop thinking about your crush, you're more likely to obsess over them. And this is the chemical basis potentially of why. Change number four is an increase in oxytocin. And oxytocin is known as the love hormone or the bonding hormone. And it's what's involved in the bonding relationship of a mother and her child. Change number five, in early stages of love, there's a decreased activity in some parts of the prefrontal cortex. And this part of the brain is involved with things like judgment and decision making. So when you're in love, a decreased level activity in this regions could actually lead to an overlooking of the person's flaws, potentially leading to help obsess over a partner and become less likely to regard them objectively. And this decrease in some parts of the frontal cortex may help explain why love is blind. And it can indeed take over your mind. Love is blind. While there are many other physical and psychological components that fit into the mix, it's important to remember we still don't know much about how love works. Yet, somehow, we all seem to know when we feel it. That's all, folks. We're going to keep this short and sweet. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's called Mental Health Nation for weekly videos on your health, on the body, and the brain. Okay? So hit that subscribe button, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Peace.